In this video, I will explain the exercise about the thermal bath in Iceland. We have a thermal bath over here where water is flowing in with a rate of Vm and flowing out also with Vm, and this is exactly the same since the amount of water inside the bath stays equal. The water coming in has a temperature of Tin and flowing out has a temperature of Tw. And we assume that the bath is ideally mixed, and therefore the water inside the bath is also Tw, which stands for T water. The outside temperature I called To, T outside, and also a Vq, or a heat flow, is going from the water inside the bath to the outside. Then I have some numbers written over here, which is the water flowing in, the outside temperature, the mass flowing in and out, the heat capacity of the water inside of the bath, the area, or better, the contact area between the air and the bath. And then we also know that the heat flux is an alpha, a constant, times the area times the difference in temperature between the bath and the outside temperature. One exercise was to determine the units of alpha. If you write out the units of the other ones, you can easily compute the units of alpha, which is joules per square meters times Kelvin times seconds. And alpha was given was 1200. Now I will use the thermal energy balance to determine the temperature of the bath. dU divided by dt is Vm times the difference in internal energy plus the heat flux plus the production of internal energy. To calculate Tw, I can say that the amount of internal energy over time does not change, or we have a steady state situation. So dU over dt is zero. Also, there's no production of internal energy inside the bath, our control volume, so this term is also zero. I can fill this in. Watch out, since the heat flux is going from the inside of the bath to the outside of the bath, and therefore you have to use a minus sign. And I can write Vq is Vm times delta U. And the internal energy is equal to the heat capacity times the temperature. If we now fill in the equation for Vq on the left side and fill in the heat capacity times temperature for the internal energy on the right side, we can get the following equation, in which you have the TWs over there, which is the one we want to know. Now I can fill this in a powerful calculator and get the Tw out, but I will do this by hand for you so you can follow this as well. I can bring the temperatures of the water to the left side, which is Tw times alpha times A plus Vm times the heat capacity in brackets is Vm times the heat capacity times the T flowing in plus alpha times A times the T outside. And then I will get the equation for the temperature of the water. If you cannot follow this right now, just stop the video and take a good look at it. And I will mark this one right here. All the variables on the right sides are knowns, so I can compute the temperature right now with filling in every number I have got already. And I will do this right now here for you. And eventually we will get 31 0.7 degrees Celsius, which is actually quite a nice temperature to swim in, especially when it's quite cold outside. Now, the next question was to calculate the energy loss to the air, or actually the heat flow. So, what is asked is to calculate Vq. And we know the equation for Vq, which is alpha times the area times delta T. These are also numbers we know, especially since we calculated the T of the water. So we fill in the numbers and we get 60 million joules per second, which is 60,000 kilojoules per second. Then, what was asked was, what if alpha was a higher number? What happens then to the bath? Well, if alpha is higher, Pq is larger. Then, if the heat flux is larger, this means more heat is flowing out of the bath into the air. So we have more heat loss. More heat loss results in a cooler bath. So if the alpha is higher, the bath will cool. Thank you for listening, and I hope this has helped you so you can go on with the next set of questions.